Hello children, how are you today? I must confess, I have really missed you. I hope you're having a nice time, enjoying your holiday and having fun too. It's so nice to have you online today. This is library class. In this class, we're going to be looking at lending and borrowing of books. Lending and borrowing of books. What are we expected to learn today? Number one, we want to learn the meaning of the terms lending and borrowing. Number two, to be able to mention the rules governing the use of library books. And number three, to borrow and return books on due dates and in good condition. What is lending and what is borrowing? Have you ever given something out to somebody and you're expecting to get it back? Then you're lending to that person. And if you've ever taken anything from somebody to be returned at a later time, then you are borrowing. Lending therefore means giving out books to pupils and expecting them to return the books after reading. Remember, after reading, this means you are expected to read every book you borrow from the library. What is borrowing? It means to take a book for a period of time. Who is the lender and who is the borrower? I, the librarian, am the lender and you, the pupil, is the borrower. What to do when you need to borrow a book from the library? Number one, borrow and return your books in good condition. In good condition, this means that your books must be returned intact, not torn, and not dirty. You must not misplace a library book. Keep your books properly. Number two, how many books or how many days can I keep a book? 1 week. You are allowed to keep a book for just 1 week. How many books can I borrow per time? Oh, you are allowed to borrow just 1 book at a time. 1 book at a time. Now that you know what lending and borrowing means and what you need to do when you need to borrow a book from the library, I'd like you to join me next week as we learn how to take care of our books. All right then, bye, and enjoy the rest of your day.
Marie was delighted when she heard her. We're getting a pet, and we're getting it today. They got in the car and drove to the store where there were cats and dogs, but just one dinosaur. Marie cried with glee.
A pet dinosaur is the pet for me. I have friends with dogs and some with cats, and even some with birds and rats. But in our neighborhood, it's plain to see that no one will have a pet quite like me.
The dinosaur said,
"Can I go home with you?"
Then he gave Marie a hug and a high five too. Marie said,
I've got a new place for your new home. It's the perfect space for you to roam. In the backyard is where you can stay, where there's lots of room for you to play.
Wow, there's lots of space for me to roam. Wow, there's lots of space for me to...
Marie had an idea.
Hey, let's go for a walk.
Everywhere they went, people would talk. He's so big.
Look at those feet.
Where is he from?
What does he eat?
He's big and has a lot of teeth. He stomps and snarls and snores when he sleeps. He's so large that he shakes the ceiling and the floor. Here comes Marie and her pet dinosaur. Will you look at it?
Oh my!
You don't see that every day!
Wow! Here they come! Will you look at that?
I don't know what to think of that!
Marie said,
don't be scared, my pet's the best of all. He looks mean and scary, but he's not at all. Although his eyes are red and his teeth are long, he's meek and mild, and he knows right from wrong.
The pet dinosaur wanted to go to school. He said,
learning ABCs will be really cool.
Marie replied,
okay, pet dinosaur, go too. Here's your new backpack